Madam Chairman, thank you very much. And panelists, thank you for your time in discussing an issue of great significance to the small businesses throughout our communities out here. And as all of you know, over 70% of the jobs in this country are provided by small business. And it's important that as the Congress considers climate change legislation, the interests of small businesses and family farms throughout the country are protected. As we move forward in on climate change, we must tread carefully, striving for a bipartisan consensus with a full understanding of the consequences of both inaction and action. And with that, Mr. Kavanaugh, determining which entities will be regulated under a cap-and-trade system is a key issue for the small businesses out there, or the business community. Considering many small businesses are considered low emitters, would it be your opinion that only the larger or largest emitters be regulated?
Well, certainly that's the place to start, sir. And as a don't know if I can comment on not being an owner of a small business, if I can comment on how they should be regulated. But certainly, I think I've pointed out that there's strong relationships between large and small emitters, you know, in the within the economy. And on hearing the previous statements from the gentleman to my left, you know, I think they've made the point that it's still not a one size fits all package, and that some, you know, some common sense and customization would need to occur.
How do we determine the proper threshold at which a greenhouse gases should be regulated, in your opinion, and where should that threshold be? Or do you have an opinion today?
I don't have an opinion on whether the threshold that's established, which is 25,000, is too high or too low. It seems to be from the coalitions that we're part of in the industrial sector that it's not unreasonable.
Okay. Yeah. Any other panelists want to kick in your opinion on that?
The only thing I might add is that, and it kind of gets back to the issue of, if nothing happens here, what will EPA do under the Clean Air Act? I was at a meeting earlier this morning where a former EPA employee said that under the Clean Air Act, their target for regulating emitters begins at 25 tons, not 25,000 tons, but 25 tons. That's way too low.
Yeah.
I mean, that would have an enormous deleterious impact across our whole industry. And so we're certainly, it kind of gets back to the point that we think it makes a whole lot more sense to cap the large emitters and then to allow these market forces that we've been talking about through offsets and things like that to help provide incentives to get the kind of reductions from other sectors of the economy, such as agriculture.
Okay. Thank you. Mr. Yoder, as a farmer, in your opinion, what role could the U.S. agriculture sector play in helping to reduce greenhouse gases through offsets, if any?
Well, one of the things that we can do is we can devise a system, a protocol that can create these incentives for farmers to go ahead and sequester carbon. And that's the thing that I would encourage us all to think about, and not just thinking in a very narrow pattern, that there's lots of things out there that we can possibly do in the future that we haven't even thought about today. So one of the things that originally we're thinking of is sequestering carbon in the soil by conservation tillage as we go through, and we can improve it as I said in my earlier testimony, with some real scientific evaluation and what's possible. What the USDA can do, though, is EPA sets out parameters of what needs to be done and what is a real and verifiable credit, USDA, I think their role would be to design a protocol that they can put in place that they could go ahead and implement and give to the farmers, because we have contact with them all the time anyway, and then they could be part of the verification system, and it could be very, very low cost. The biggest thing that we have to do in all this is, regardless of where that threshold is that you were talking about before, is if we limit the amount of credits that can be created out there, as we know, we can agriculture alone can come up with can mitigate up to 20% of the total greenhouse gases. Let's take the lid off and let's create those low cost ones so it'll cost everyone less to participate.
How do we ensure that for farmers the value of any cap and trade legislation exceeds the cost?
Well, that's a big thing. If it costs more to implement than you get back out of it, then it's not going to be a win for anyone. That's why it's really important to have instead of basing it on the project, base it on protocols and things like that that are scientifically proven. It greatly inhibits the cost overruns and makes it more efficient. So yeah, if we can't get as much as what it costs to do, then nobody wins.
Okay. Thank you very much, Madam Chairman. I believe my time has elapsed.